In the beginning, God crafted the land, a masterpiece of creation detailed in Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 to 10. He bestowed upon humanity the responsibility of stewardship, as outlined in Joshua chapter 21, verse 43, and Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 21. Throughout history, the pursuit of land has often been intertwined with conflict, from ancient wars to the devastation of World Wars 1 and 2. Yet, amidst the turmoil, a different approach emerges, the Dunamese Christian Fellowship's method of possessing the land. They embody this through the story of Dian Hari Church, a testament to their belief in expansion through daughter churches. It encompasses the hearts and minds of the people inhabiting the land. Through initiatives like the March for Jesus, De Groots, street evangelism, miracle crusades, and Bible studies, they strive to truly possess the land by transforming lives and spreading the message of love and salvation. Indeed, possessing the land extends far beyond physical boundaries. It encompasses the hearts and souls of the people who inhabit it. It involves cultivating a community where love, justice, and righteousness flourish, where every individual is valued and empowered to reach their fullest potential. As we strive to possess the land, we must also endeavor to touch the lives of those within it, sharing the message of hope, redemption, and reconciliation. In doing so, we not only fulfill our divine mandate, but also participate in the ongoing work of God's kingdom here on earth. The journey of possessing the land promised by God is a perpetual one, marked by both physical and spiritual conquests. It is a commitment to continue the work of stewardship and transformation, never ceasing in the pursuit of fulfilling God's promises. Through unwavering faith, dedication, and the power of community, we embark on this journey, knowing that as long as we remain steadfast, God will guide us and ensure that His promises are fulfilled. So, let us never stop possessing the land God has promised His people, for in doing so, we not only inherit His blessings, but also become instruments of His love and grace in the world.